Hey everybody out there in the Archviz community, this is Adam Zollinger with learnarchviz.com, and I wanted to quickly make a video to talk about Unreal Engine 5, which today Epic Games released a trailer of, a preview of, a sneak peek of, and it's absolutely amazing, and I think it has some huge implications for Archviz moving forward in the future. So let's just start looking at this here. If you haven't checked it out, after you watch this video, go check out the full video, Unreal Engine.
Here at Epic Games.
Okay, I'm Jean Plateau, art director of the special project.
These guys are introducing who they are, what they've been working on. Let's go straight to the project, and I'll tell you basically what I think is super important about this. Obviously, this is a demo. It looks absolutely amazing. They're going to talk a little bit about what we're looking at here.
Before we continue, let's stop a moment and take a look at some of the key features of this demo. Much of what you see was built with Quixel Megascan assets, but instead of using the game versions, we use the cinematic versions, which would typically only be used in film.
Okay, right there. If you have ever used Megascans and you've brought in the cinematic versions of things, you know they're really heavy. They're photo scanned, they have huge textures on them, or potentially they can, and they're going to say these are all 8K textures. But just the model of them, just the geometry is huge, and it bogs you down. Even in 3ds Max and V-Ray, bogs you down big time because it's really heavy. And yet they're saying that this is all cinematic level Megascan stuff, photogrammetry. All in this scene, which is all happening in real time. Okay, so amazing.
There are around 1 million triangles each. And thanks to virtual texturing, they all use 8K textures as well.
Whoa.
NANITE can render an insane number of triangles very quickly. There are over 1 billion triangles of source geometry in each frame that NANITE crunches down losslessly to around 20 million drawn triangles.
Dude, okay, so enormous number of polygons. He's talking about NANITE, which is one of the technologies that they're introducing here. And he, at the beginning, he's talking about how they've been working on two problems. They want global illumination to be done extremely realistically and in real time. That was one of the huge improvements that needs to be made. And then he wanted to be able to solve the problem of kind of seamless geometry, huge amounts of geometry where the artist has full control and they don't have to worry about endless LODs, levels of detail, and worrying about having to save polygons and sacrifice the look of their scene. So he wanted to solve those two problems, and NANITE is what they came up with. Some technology, I don't know how they're doing it, but it gives them basically unlimited power in making humongous scenes, like enormous amounts of polygons. We'll see it right here. And then he talks about the other issue that they've been working on with the global illumination. Also amazing.
What does that many triangles look like? This isn't noise.
Whoa.
These are the triangles, each a different color. Most are so small that they look like noise. NANITE achieves detail down to the pixel, which means triangles are often the size of pixels.
That's all polygons.
This amount of geometric detail requires shadows to be
insane
as well, and NANITE can do that too. Speaking of lighting, all of the lighting in this demo is completely dynamic, with the power of LUMON that even includes multi-bounce global illumination.
Okay, so LUMON is the other technology that they're introducing, and it's doing real-time global illumination. These are all dynamic lights in this scene with that enormous amount of polygons, and it looks awesome. He's going to demonstrate it a little more right here.
No light maps, no baking here. Without GI,
crazy.
All of that beautiful lighting is gone. With LUMON enabled, we can move the light and the bounce changes instantly.
Dude.
Okay, let's keep going.
Okay, so right there, we've solved the two issues that, in my mind, are the biggest barriers for Archviz artists, right? If you're, you know, real-time already gets rid of render times, but the quality's not there. Unless you have real-time perfect GI, and the geometry isn't an issue, and you can make it as heavy as you want, right? Those two issues are taken care of, then who needs static rendering anymore, right? We're just going to do everything in real time. That's amazing. I thought we were going to be years out from that kind of technology leap. These guys are showing proof of concept, you know, today. It's like, to me, we just jumped into the future right here.
We've made some great additions to our audio system as well.
Okay, so they talk about audio and animation improvements, which are all awesome as well, especially for the gaming industry. For the ArcViz industry, we're going to look at some of this other stuff that is going on in here. Okay, so this is
illumination means specular as well, which you can see on all the metal surfaces.
Yeah, this is all real-time lighting.
You can even see the Niagara-powered bugs reacting to the light.
Awesome.
Lumen not only reacts to moving light sources, but also changes in geometry.
Okay, this part's super cool. Look at that. Real-time dynamic lighting. So good.
Remember we mentioned high-poly assets? This statue was imported directly from ZBrush and is more than 33 million triangles. No baking of normal maps, no authored LODs.
Crazy, right? Have you ever tried sculpting in ZBrush 33 million polygons? It's heavy even in ZBrush, and yet somehow it's in here working flawlessly and rendering at whatever, 30 times per second. Awesome, and it gets even better.
And we can do more than a single statue. There are nearly 500 of that exact statue at the same detail level placed in this room for a total of over 16 billion triangles from statues alone.
Oh my goodness.
Over this entire demo, there are hundreds of billions of triangles.
Here comes some more dynamic lighting. Just awesome. Amazing amount of geometry in here.
So with NANITE, you have limitless geometry, and with LUMON, you have fully dynamic lighting and global illumination, all running on a PlayStation 5.
Okay, that's another important note. This is PlayStation 5. This isn't some insane machine, right? Just so, so good. Okay, you can see visually this is stunning. The geometry and the lighting are both fantastic. And obviously this took many artists, many months probably to make. But the technology is what's amazing. So I'll let this play out at low volume, but I basically want to talk about what this means for ArcViz. And I think you guys know, I've talked about for years now how UE4 is going to be a game changer and is in a lot of ways a game changer for ArcViz. Because with real time, if once you build your scene, you have everything now. You have any rendering you want, you just have to set up the camera. You have any animation you want, you just have to set up and animate a camera. And, you know, it renders almost instantly. And you also have a full VR walkthrough of the scene. So this is much more powerful than just a static image of something that you'd render out of V-Ray, obviously. But the barrier has always been, but it doesn't look quite as real. It looks a little bit like a video game or whatever. But that's because of ray tracing and global illumination, right? If that can be done in real time, like they're demonstrating here, and if the geometry can be as complex as we need it to be, then there is no barriers anymore, in my opinion. So I'm interested to see how this works out in reality when we actually start doing real-life projects in it. But this is the kind of thing I've been hoping for and just kind of assuming, like, over the next decade, we would start getting there and UE4 would start completely replacing other render engines. But amazingly, this that they're demonstrating today really looks like it is a huge leap forward in a short amount of time. That's what it looks like to me. So very interested to try this out, very interested to see, and I think it will have huge implications for the future of ArcViz and how we do our day-to-day work. So let me know what you guys think in the comments about this, where you see your workflow going, how you see integrating this kind of technology. And if you're like me, if you think that it's going to kind of replace what we've been doing for the last, you know, two decades and change it to something kind of completely new, kind of a whole different way of thinking about things. Maybe some of you have already completely transitioned to real-time stuff. Anyway, let me know what you think in the comments. If you are ready to start learning real-time stuff, you can always take my Unreal Engine 4 classes. Follow the links below to check those out. I even have a mini course on UE4 that is free So check that out. If you want my 3D models of high polygon furniture that you can use in your scenes, you can follow the links for that too. Okay, make sure to subscribe and let me know what you think of Unreal Engine 5, what it means for the industry in the comments below. Thanks.